This is going to be round four, the finals of the Gerudo Flash Tournament number 21. And my opponent in the finals is Robbie_8MileGPS. And we're going to be facing each other on the map that I selected, Crossroads. And you can already tell what kind of build I'm going to bring. I'm going to bring a Melee Rush style build. I am going to bring one less cav than usual. I'm going to bring 5 cavalry for this battle. He beat Pariah in this tournament right before he faced me. I was hoping to face Pariah in the finals, but because I wanted to get revenge against him for beating me in the Gerudo Flash tournament number 19. I wanted to post our battle, but the file was corrupt because of the recent patch for the cav. And any replay with a ton of cav in it got patched and corrupted. So I couldn't post that. I still have that replay. I want to show it, but it shows me winning. So I felt wrong. I could show it to you, but it shows me winning, and I don't like that because that didn't happen. He beat me. So if he has an uncorrupt replay, then I'll gladly post it, and I hope he does. All right, so I asked Zarup if he had a replay of it, and he says, I'll check, but I'll see later. I really do want to post that battle. It was a good matchup. It's the first time I faced Pariah in a 1v1, and I saved it for that reason, too, because it was such a good matchup, and he's also a YouTuber. I will link his channel once I get a good replay that isn't corrupted of our battle. I mean, I'll show it, but it's corrupted. It shows me winning, so it may be confusing. So on to the explanation of this battle. This battle is about 9 minutes, and the battle only lasts a minute. The rest of the time is nothing but repositioning, back and forth, capturing the dojos. This guy beat Pariah in round 3. And I was talking to Pariah, I was like, how did he beat you? I thought I was facing you in the finals. He goes, yeah, bro, yeah, this dude, he sat still. He let me get all the dojos, and I attacked him head on, and he waits for you. He's patient, he gets his own little dojo, and he just sits there. That's what he said, pretty much. So he said, take your time. He sits there. You have all the time in the world to get dojos, so just attack him where you feel like you could beat him and do what you gotta do. That's what he pretty much said, and I'm doing just that. I focused on a flank that he wasn't nearby, so he just gave up these two dojos, the dojos that I needed most, the farmhouse and the sword dojo. He's gonna get the archery. He does want this because he does have a gun build. Does have 3 Shogatai, he does have a lot of good guns as well. Vermilion Bird Force, though I really don't like this gun with gun armies. I mean, it's not really good for gun armies. It's a lot better with Bushido armies because it inspires nearby units, but the reload and accuracy of this unit isn't as good as like a Imperial Infantry. It's not as good, and it's slightly more expensive by 40 more funds, so I don't recommend you take this army with gun armies, but with a melee rush army, it's awesome because it inspires nearby units in its radius. So can you imagine sending melee with this gun unit, following behind, inspiring them? It's a good combination, so I recommend it. He does have 5 cav units. He will reposition in this forest here along the line. Not all the way in the forest. He will stay connected to this archery dojo. He will contest this against me. So I'm going to speed this up. I really don't want y'all staring at this battle for 8 minutes. Because you can see I'm repositioning back and forth, back and forth. I'm looking for any exploits. I was about to charge his unit, but I saw that he was moving into the range of his Azuri Dragon Force. And I didn't want it. My expensive cav unit to get easily shot up. It was a Shogatai that was a Shogunate Guard cav that I was about to charge the back of his lines with, but I didn't want them to get shot up and easily taken out by an inexpensive Azuri Dragon Force. That would have been really stupid on my part. So I was going to charge here, but I didn't like that angle because he still had a gun. Oh man, not this again. God damn it. Alright. I was about to commentate on a naval battle that wasn't even happening. I was going to charge his side until I noticed his gun was facing this direction. I was like, no, I don't want to get into a cav engagement with a gun staring right at me. So that's really bad. I'm just going to wait a little bit. I'm going to bring up my guns, but I realized his unit was behind a hill, so I wouldn't be able to shoot it. But he noticed this that was trying to shoot him. So he backed up and he faced it in that in this unit's direction. So I was like, okay, that was a good move, because now his gun isn't facing in my cav's direction. So I brought my spears all the way back over here. At first I was going to charge head on, but I was like, let me try this direction again, because his gun isn't facing my cav. So I was like, okay, let me maneuver just a little bit more, see what he does, wait a little bit. Speed along again. So I was getting my troops ready. I'm going to use a diversionary tactic over here. I'm going to move my cav. He's going to do the same. I knew he would. Move my cav here at first. You're going to see the moments. Look over here first where my mouse is. Over here. That's a diversion. I'm not charging yet. I will charge soon. But first he's going to look at my units. He's going to send his cav. You can tell he's looking over here. He's moving his cav. Moving his cav. I'm going to charge him. Then, soon enough, I will commit on the side. I'm just maneuvering. First I maneuver forward, then I move back, then I move my spear levy up, use loose formation, then I attack. So that was a feint over here. That was the diversionary tactic to lure his guns and his cav in this direction. He even brought his general in this direction as well. So it is as soon as he moved units over there, I was like, okay, now's the time to strike. I'm going to send one of my units after this unit was about to charge my Shogunate Guard cav, but I intercepted it with my own, so that dealt him even more casualties. I countercharged his JRQ with my Shogunate Guard cav. Mine is better attack, but I'm not going to be in sustained melee. I'm going to charge right on through into the back of his guns. I'm going to send my Spear Levy into his JRQ. I'm going to send my other Shogunate Guard cav around this flank here to charge his JRQ. He intercepted it, and he's going to try and shoot my Shogunate Guard cav with his general, but I don't mind that. I'm going to send my Shogatai into his Shogatai. At first, I was sending my Shogatai against his guns, but then I saw he was sending his Shogatai, so I instead changed targets to them instead. My guns are busy shooting his guns, but his guns are busy shooting my Shogatai. So as that's happening, his guns are getting even more depleted and shot up, while mine are safe. And he's only shooting up his own Shogatai at the back as well. So I will take my cav from the melee fight, and I will charge the back of his guns now. And I've broken up his melee, and they are being charged from the front by my swords, being charged from the back by my cav, and they're being shot up in support by my guns. So he's losing on all fronts. So by repositioning and attacking where you feel like you can win, look at the outcome of this battle. By taking your time, I took 8 minutes. People were spectating this match and they were laughing. They were like, can you imagine? This battle was 9 minutes long. 8 minutes to reposition and 1 minute of fighting. So you can see why everybody thought of this humorously. They're like, Point Man, you noob. It took you 9 minutes to get this done. I was like, well, it took 8 minutes to maneuver, so yeah. Constant waiting and stare down, see the outcome by just taking your time. You gotta take the initiative though, you can't just sit there. I deployed 1,440, I lost 599, I killed 1,076, my opponent deployed 1,380, he lost 1,084, he killed 549. GG, well played, and this isn't it. The finals are best 2 out of 3, so we have to face each other 2 more times at least. If I beat him again, then I win. If he wins, then I have to face him in a tiebreaker. So we'll see you then. See y'all then.